Hello students, in today's session we will discuss fundamentals of structural analysis. In previous sessions we discussed static indeterminate structures and degree of static indeterminacy of different structures such as beam, plane frame, trusses and grid. Now in this session we will discuss kinematic indeterminate structures and degree of kinematic indeterminacy of different structures such as beam, trusses, plane frames and grids. We will also solve numerical to calculate degree of kinematic indeterminacy of beams and trusses. So let's start with definition of kinematic indeterminate structures. If displacement component of joints of a structure cannot be determined by compatibility equation alone, the structure is said to be kinematic indeterminate structure. Now, degree of kinematic indeterminacy. For us, it is very important to know how much our structure is kinematic indeterminate. And for that, we need to calculate degree of kinematic indeterminacy. Degree of kinematic indeterminacy is also known as degree of freedom and it is denoted by dk. And degree of kinematic indeterminacy is number of additional equations necessary to determine all independent displacement components. So, before calculating degree of kinematic indeterminacy of different structures, first of all, let us discuss displacement component at supports. So, we know that there are major three types of the supports: roller supports, hinge support and fixed support. And displacement component at the support depend on reaction at the supports. So, let us start with roller support. As we already discussed in previous sessions, roller support always offers one vertical reaction. So, roller support does not allow the beam to displace in vertical direction. So, number of displacement in roller support will be one rotation and one horizontal displacement. Now, in case of hinge support always offers two reactions, one in horizontal direction and one in vertical direction. Therefore, in case of hinge support, horizontal displacement and vertical displacement is not possible. So, in case of hinge support, only rotation can be possible. Now, in case of fixed support, we know that fixed support offers three reactions, one horizontal, one vertical and one moment. Hence, fixed support does not allow horizontal displacement, vertical displacement and rotation. Therefore, we can say that there will be no displacement in case of fixed support. So, for the calculation of kinematic indeterminacy, we need to remember reaction at the support and accordingly displacement possible at supports. Now, let us solve a numerical to calculate degree of kinematic indeterminacy of the beam without pin or the hinge. So, here is the equation to calculate dk of the beam without pin. Equation of dk for the beam is equal to 3j minus capital R, where j is number of joints and capital R is number of reactions. Now, degree of kinematic indeterminacy neglecting axial deformation is called DKNAD. And in case of beams without pin, DKNAD is equal to dk minus m, where m is number of members. So, using these equations, let's calculate degree of kinematic indeterminacy of the beam without pin or hinge. So, in the given figure, the beam has two supports, one hinge support and other roller support. and we need to calculate dk, degree of kinematic indeterminacy, and dk NAD of this given beam. So, for calculation of dk and dk NAD, first of all, we need to calculate capital R, which is number of reaction, small m, which is number of members, and j, which is number of joint for this given beam. So, let's calculate capital R of the given beam. So, we know that hinge support always offers two reactions, one horizontal and one vertical. And roller support always offer one reaction. So total number of reactions of this given beam will be 2 plus 1 is 3. Now number of joints. So here in this given beam there are two joints, one at extreme left end and other at extreme right end. So total number of joints J of this given beam is equal to 2. Now m is number of members, so in given beam number of member is only 1. Now let's put value of capital R and J in equation of dk to calculate degree of kinematic indeterminacy of this given beam. So dk is equal to 3j minus capital R, and value of J is equal to 2 and R is equal to 3. If we put these values in equation of dk, then we will get answer of dk is equal to 3. It means that in a given beam, total 3 displacements are possible. Our answer can also be verified from the figure. So, let's check our answer from the figure. As discussed earlier, hinge support offer two reactions, horizontal and vertical. Therefore, at the hinge support, horizontal displacement and vertical displacement is not possible. So, at hinge support, always rotation displacement is possible. Again, in roller support, vertical reaction will be there. Therefore, in case of roller support, only horizontal displacement and rotation is possible. So, total number of displacement possible in this given beam will be rotation at hinge support, rotation and horizontal displacement at roller support, which is equal to 3. And our answer using equation of dk is also 3. So, we can say that our answer is correct. Now, let's calculate dk NAD using equation. Equation of dk NAD is equal to dk minus m. Dk, as we calculated, 3 and m is 1. So, dk NAD is equal to 3 minus 1. We get answer of dk NAD is equal to 2. It means degree of kinematic indeterminacy of this given beam by neglecting axial deformation using equation is equal to 2. Now, let's verify our answer from the figure. So, remember one thing. In case of beams, axial deformation will be in horizontal direction only. So, if we neglect this horizontal displacement, then from this figure, number of displacement possible after neglecting axial deformation will be two rotations at both the ends. So, our answer using equation of dk NAD is also 2. So, our answer is correct. Now, let's calculate another numerical. Here, the given beam has three supports, one fixed support and two roller supports, and we need to calculate dk and dk NAD. So, let's start with R. Here, we know that fixed support offers three reactions and each roller support offers one vertical reaction. So, total number of reactions of this given beam will be 3 plus 1 plus 1 is equal to 5. Now, number of joint of this given beam will be 1, 2, 3, and this free end is also considered as a joint. So, number of joint will be 4. And number of members of this given beam will be 1, 2, and 3. Now, let's put value of R and J in equation of dk. So, equation of dk for the beam is 3j minus r. So, we can say that dk is equal to 3 multiplied with j, j is 4 minus r and r is 5. So, we get answer dk is equal to 7. It means that in a given beam, total 7 number of displacement is possible. Now, let's verify our answer from the figure. So, here at a fixed support, there are total 3 reactions in horizontal, vertical and moment. So, at a fixed support, no displacement is possible. Now, in case of roller support, reaction will be in only one direction, which is vertical. So, vertical displacement at roller support is not possible. So, at roller support, two displacements are possible, one rotation and one horizontal. And at free end, there is no support. So, at free end, total three types of the displacements are possible, horizontal, vertical and rotation. So, total number of displacement possible in this given beam will be 2 at first roller support plus 2 at second roller support means 4 plus 3 at free support means 7, which is equal to answer that we get using equation. So, we can say that our answer is correct. Now, let's calculate dk and ad, means degree of kinematic indeterminacy of the beam by neglecting axial deformation. And in case of beam, horizontal displacement is called axial deformation. So, by equation, dk and ad is equal to dk minus m. Here, dk as we calculated is 7 and m is 3. So, dk and ad is equal to 4. It means that in the given beam, degree of kinematic indeterminacy neglecting axial deformation will be 4. Now, let's verify our answer from this figure. So, here total 3 horizontal displacements are there, each at roller support and one at free end. So, if we deduct this 3 horizontal displacement from total possible displacement, then from the figure we get answer 4, which is equal to the answer that we calculated using equation. Hence, our answer is correct. Now, let's solve numerical to calculate degree of kinematic indeterminacy of the beam with pin or hinge. So, here are the equation to calculate dk of the beam with pin. So, dk is equal to 3 in bracket j plus j dash minus capital R plus RR. Here, j is number of joints, j dash is number of pin, capital R is number of reactions and RR is number of members connected to pin minus 1. Now, equation of dk and ad is equal to dk minus m, where m is equal to number of members. Now, let's calculate numerical. So, here the given beam has 3 supports, 1 fixed support and 2 roller supports, and the beam have 2 pins. Now, let's calculate number of reactions of this given beam. So, at fixed end, number of reactions will be 3 and at each roller support, number of reactions will be 1. So, total number of reactions of this given beam will be 3 plus 1 plus 1, which is equal to 5. Now, J. J is number of joints. So, total number of joints of this given beam is 1 plus 1 plus 1 means 3. And J dash is number of pins. So in this given beam, there are 2 pins. So J dash is equal to 2. Now let's calculate RR for the first pin. For the first pin, number of member connected to the pin are 2. And RR is equal to number of members connected to pin minus 1. So for the first pin, RR is equal to 2 minus 1. Similarly, for the second pin, RR is equal to number of member connected to pin minus 1. And here, number of member connected to pin are 2. So 2 minus 1, which is equal to 1. So total RR of this given beam is equal to 2 minus 1 for the first pin plus 2 minus 1 for second pin. So we get RR is equal to 2. Now, number of members of this given beam. So number of members are 1, 2, 3 and 4. So M is equal to 4. Now, let's put value of R, J, J dash and RR in DK equation to calculate degree of kinematic indeterminacy of this given beam. So DK is equal to 3 in bracket J plus J dash minus capital R plus RR. So here DK is equal to 3 in bracket value of J is 3 and J dash is 2. So 3 plus 2. Value of capital R is 5, so minus 5 plus RR is 2. So we put RR is equal to 2. So we get answer of DK is equal to 12. It means that in a given beam, total 12 number of displacements are possible. Let's verify our answer from the figure. So here at this fixed support, no displacement is possible. And at a roller support, total 2 displacements are possible, one rotation and one horizontal. Now remember one thing, at a pin, total 4 displacements are possible. 2 rotations, one horizontal and one vertical. Here we have 2 pins, so total number of displacement possibles at pin in given beams will be equal to 4 plus 4, which is 8. And number of displacement possible at roller support will be 2 plus 2, 4. So 8 for the pin and 4 for the roller support. So we get answer of DK from this figure is equal to 12, which is similar to the answer that we calculated using equation. Hence, our answer is okay. Now, let's calculate DK NAD. So, DK NAD is equal to DK minus M. And value of DK as calculated is 12 and value of M is 4. So, DK NAD is equal to 8. DK NAD is the degree of kinematic indeterminacy of the beam neglecting axial deformation, and in case of beam, axial deformation is horizontal displacement. So here in our case, horizontal displacements from the figure you can calculate it is 4. 1 at first pin, 2nd at first roller support, 3rd at second pin and 4th at roller support. So total number of horizontal displacement of this given beam is 4, and if we neglect this horizontal displacement, then total number of displacement possible in this given beam is 8, which is similar to the answer we calculated from the equation. Now let's solve numerical to calculate degree of kinematic indeterminacy of plane truss. And here is the equation of DK for truss. So DK is equal to 2J minus R, where J is number of joints and R is equal to number of reactions. Now, in case of plane truss, while calculating degree of kinematic indeterminacy, it is important to remember two points. So, first point is that for plane truss, all forces are acting axially. It means that all deformation that is occur in case of plane truss will be axial deformation. And if we neglect all axial deformation, then we will get DKNAD, which is kinematic indeterminacy. After neglecting axial deformation, we will get it zero. And second point is, for plane truss at each pin joint, number of displacement will be 2, one vertical and one horizontal. Now let's solve a numerical. So here in given figure, one plane truss is there and the truss has two support, one hinge support and other roller support. So we need to calculate DK, means degree of kinematic indeterminacy of this given truss. So let's start with calculation of capital R, which is number of reactions. So in case of hinge support, number of reactions will be 2, and for the roller support, number of reaction will be 1. So 2 plus 1, we get R is equal to 3. Now let's calculate joint of the truss. So we will start with this left joint. This is first, second, third and fourth. So number of joint in case of given figure will be 4. And number of members, let's calculate number of member. So this is first, second, third, four and five. So number of member of given truss is 5. Now let's put value of J and R in equation of DK to calculate DK. So DK is equal to 2J minus R. So that we can say that DK is equal to 2 in bracket value of J is 4 minus reactions is equal to 3. So we get DK is equal to 5. It means we can say that total number of possible displacements of this given truss is equal to 5. Now let's verify our answer from the figure. So as point number 2, for the plane truss at each pin joint, number of displacement is 2. So here pin joint are 2 and at each pin joint number of displacement possible is equal to 2. So here we get total displacement for the pin joint as 4 and one displacement possible at roller support. So total number of displacement possible of this given plane truss from the figure is 5, which is equal to the answer we get using equation. So our answer is correct. And in case of plane truss, all deformations are in axial deformation, so we get DKNAD is equal to 0. Now let's solve one more numerical. So here the given truss has 3 supports, 2 hinge support and 1 roller support. So let's start with calculation of capital R. So each hinge support reactions will be 2, so 2 plus 2, and reaction at roller is 1, so R is equal to 5. Now let's calculate number of joints. So we start with left first joint and we will move in a clockwise direction. So this is joint number 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 and 6. So total number of joints of this given beam is equal to 6. So let's put value of J and R in equation of DK. So dk is equal to 2j minus r and value of j is equal to 6 and r is equal to 5. So dk for this given beam is equal to 7. It means total possible displacement of this given truss is 7. From figure you can see that here there are 3 pin joints and at each pin joint, as per we discussed earlier, total number of possible displacements are 2. So total possible displacement of this given truss at 3 pins will be 2 plus 2 plus 2 is 6, and 1 horizontal displacement possible at roller support V. So at roller support, so from this figure dk of this given beam will be 7, which is equal to the answer we get from equation. And in case of trusses, dk and ad is always 0, so dk and ad is 0. So this is end of this session. In a next session we will discuss degree of kinematic indeterminacy of plane frames and grids. Thank you.